I'm gonna lay down my sword and shield down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I'm gonna lay down my sword and shield down by the riverside. Study.
Gather round my children, and I will tell you a story. Mr. Raccoon, first slide, please.
Why don't you just get a clicker?
Pardon?
A clicker, like you move your own slides.
You're sitting right by the projector.
Sitting in the back in case I wanted to leave early. If I decide to leave, fine. You happy?
Our prairie dog brothers and sisters have worked on a little song to get the mood set for our story.
He's 5 foot two and he's 6 feet four. He fights with missiles and with spears. He's all of 31 and he's only 17. He's been a soldier for a thousand years. He's a Catholic, a Hindu, an atheist, a Jain, a Buddhist and a Baptist and a Jew. And he knows he shouldn't kill, and he knows he always will kill you for me, my friend, and me for you. And he's fighting for Canada, he's fighting for France, he's fighting for the USA. And he's fighting for the Russians.
Guys,
and he's fighting
I think that's gone on long enough. That was a beautiful song. Weren't they great, everybody? I love them, just sometimes they just go and go and go. His name was Deganawidah, a man who dedicated his life to peace. His name literally meant he the thinker. And one day, he had a great vision of peace.
My small friend, I must go. I will be going on a journey. I have had a vision. The nations of the south have known nothing but war, and I must show them the ways of peace. It is my mission, and I must dedicate my life to it. I hope you understand that I may never return.
Yeah, whatever, dude. That's great. You got any more of that bird seed?
No, I do not have any bird seed, but I do have a cookie.
I'll get on that, fella.
Be careful. It is a big cookie.
Yeah, have you got another one?
You don't think you've maybe had enough?
You're not my dad, man. Actually, can I get a ride home?
Have you been out eating cookies again? You should call your sponsor.
And maybe you should call Dr. Shut Up.
Flip, that doesn't even make sense. These cookies are destroying your brain.
So Deganawidah headed south in a mystical canoe to spread his message of peace. However, he quickly learned the people of the south could not understand his northern jibber-jabber.
Brothers, let us turn from war.
Let us churn a boat.
No, turn from war.
Dude, I really can't understand one word you're saying.
Not one word.
It's my accent, and it's not that bad.
Your accent's a hot fat dad.
It's like you have a mouthful of pudding.
I have come here to spread peace.
You want to spray pee? Just go, man, you're in a lake. However, you're in a canoe. That's like a round-bottom boat. I suggest you sit down, because that's terribly unsafe.
Dude, I'm loving the cuddles, but I cannot breathe.
And those who did understand him were not keen to hear his message of peace.
Brother, let's put down our weapons of war.
Put it down? Let me show you how I put this down. Boom! Chopped him right up. You like that?
No. No, I don't. That's the exact opposite of what I like.
And one day, he happened upon a warrior who was weeping by a lake. That warrior's name was Hiawatha, one of the greatest fighters of all the Haudenosaunee people. His courage in battle was known throughout the land. But he had grown weary of war.
Why do you weep here today?
I wasn't crying.
Sure, well, why is there a lot of liquid coming from your eyes?
Well, I have been truly and utterly defeated.
By my chief, the evil Todadaho.
More like the awesome Todadaho.
Todadaho, the most feared chief of all the Haudenosaunee people.
The chief practices a truly evil medicine.
I fart in my hand and I hold it over people's noses and yell, cup of cheese! That was a joke. I am pretty evil.
He wears snakes in his hair.
Snakes?
Snakes!
Snakes.
Call them my snake locks. Pretty cool, huh?
I don't know. That doesn't seem that weird.
He eats people.
People?
People.
Only free-range people. It's more expensive, but worth it. That was a joke. I'd eat anyone.
And he killed my entire family.
Gosh.
Gosh? That's it? You nearly pooped your pants over the snake thing, but apparently my family isn't a big deal.
I'm sorry for your loss, but you're a great warrior, are you not?
Does a bear poop in the wood?
What?
I mean, yes, probably the greatest.
Well, those people you killed in battle, were they not parts of people's families?
Well played.
Tell me more about this chief.
Well, there isn't much more besides that. I guess, he doesn't wear any pants.
I don't like pants.
I'm not big on pants either.
To be honest, I don't usually wear pants either.
I'm not wearing any pants.
Yo, I don't wear pants.
Yes, I get it. No one wears any pants.
Well, what about Frank?
Who?
Frank.
Who?
Frank.
Who?
Frank.
Who?
Frank.
He's a horse in jeans, and he likes to keep them clean. He's the king of the barn, if you know what I mean. He always says yes and never says nay. If you hear me now, let me hear you say, hey.
Frank.
Oh, yes. Good old Frank. Mr. Cool Guy Frank. Mr. Fancy Pants Frank. Mr. Never comes to my service, but finds a way to interrupt it every single week. Look, I got fancy legs, too, but you don't hear me banging on about it all the time. Hiawatha began to tell Deganawidah about the battle that brought him to the place he is now.
I had planned a mission. I called it Render Todadaho No Longer Alive.
You mean you wanted to kill him?
That's what I said. I'd received some intel that he'd be alone in his hut.
What was the intel?
Well, he's just always alone in his hut.
Well, I'm a private guy. I just sit up here and chill with my snakes.
So I rallied a small detachment, and we departed 0700 hours. We traveled 3 clicks east to the evil woods he called home.
Credence, really?
I like that song.
Well, it's a great song, just a little cliche.
Fair enough. Can I continue?
Of course.
On our way, I could tell my men were nervous, and I comforted them. We'd enter the evil woods just after sunrise, but I immediately felt this evil, sneaky presence.
Come on. These fools, they think they're going to catch me sleeping. People don't catch me sleeping, I catch them sleeping. But this is my hood.
My platoon and I began to get swooped upon by owls.
Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
The Iroquois believed owls to be spies of evil forces.
I need to speak to Vladimir.
Who? Who?
Houghton.
That was terrible.
We began to take heavy fire. Arrows flew from all directions. We saw no shooters, just the arrows. It was pretty weird, so we bailed. We returned to camp to find Todadaho's magic had burnt it to the ground. My men were very angry, and I think one of them called me a jerk.
You're a jerk.
I retreated deep into the woods and deep into my mind. I felt Todadaho's evil all around me. I could not stop fighting the battle. The battle for my soul, a darkness I had never known before. I awoke at night seeing my burning longhouse. I could even smell the flesh of the...
Wow.
Let's just say it's been a really rough week.
The only way you will be free is to defeat this Todadaho, and I can help you.
Yeah, I'd like to fart right in his mouth.
No, I mean you must face him and forgive him, and you will have defeated him.
Talk some crazy stuff, fella.
The only way to defeat evil is with love, not more evil.
You're a weird dude, but I like you.
Hiawatha and Deganawidah spent much time together. Hiawatha told Deganawidah of his battles, and Deganawidah taught Hiawatha how to love and find peace. Together, they were what was known as a supergroup of peacemaking. In Hiawatha, Deganawidah found a warrior that the other tribes would respect. And in Deganawidah, Hiawatha found someone who could teach him to love and find peace. And Hiawatha was able to help with the gibberish that came out of Deganawidah's mouth.
I believe it is time for us to go spread this word of peace. First, we'll go to this Todadaho.
Oh, yeah, can we do him last?
Sure, we will go and unite the tribes.
But we will need to find my men.
We can take my mystical canoe.
We could take my car.
I never understood why you people need such huge cars.
I used to call it the war wagon, but now I'm thinking the Peacemobile or the love rocket.
Why don't we just say this car runs on peace?
I like it, but technically it runs on squirrel farts. Let's ride.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
This is exactly where we started.
Yeah, my men are right over there.
What a waste of time.
Well, that's your opinion.
But Hiawatha's men would not be easily convinced. They would require a miracle to believe that Deganawidah's good magic could defeat Todadaho's evil magic.
What type of miracle do you require?
Alright, you see that tree?
What tree?
That tree.
Where?
The only tree.
I was just having fun. It's a nice tree.
Yeah. We'll climb that tree, right? Fall with it into the falls, and if you survive, we'll believe who you say you are.
Seems a bit dramatic and a waste of a tree.
Oh, don't worry, we'll use the tree.
Okay then, whenever you're ready.
The tree was cut. The Deganawidah fell into the powerful falls below.
Well, that's that.
Then suddenly, the Deganawidah appeared unharmed at the banks of the river.
Impressive.
Sure, we will go and unite the tribes.
And word of the Peacemaker's miracles and that of the reformed warrior spread throughout the five nations. The Deganawidah and Hiawatha looked to capitalize off this positive PR, and they went to speak peace with the five nations. First to the Cahuga, the people of the swamp, where they talked of love. Next to the Oneida, the people of the balancing rock, the people of the regular rocks, where they spoke of the wampum belt. Then the Mohawk, the people of the Mohawk, where they spoke of peace. And finally, to the Seneca, the people of the waterslide, where they also spoke of peace. The tribes had been united under peace. But all would be for naught if they could not reach Todadaho. They set out together to show him the power of love. But as their love grew, so did his hate. And he prepared for a showdown. Todadaho began to mock them.
The 80s called. They said, peace is for the weak.
Can you call them back? Maybe I could talk to them and say they're wrong.
What? A Delaware, a Mohawk, and a Munsee all walked into a bar and instantly agreed that you, sir, are a douche.
If these warring tribes can agree on that, then maybe they can also agree to live in peace.
You're too stupid to know you've been insulted. The 80s called and they said, peace is for chickens.
Those guys call a lot. True strength is someone who rises above their feelings of hate and pettiness to live in peace, even with their greatest enemy, to live in peace, love, and respect.
I'll show you strength. Owls, attack!
But the owls had already been defeated by love.
Ooh.
Stop loving up my owls! Well, prepare for my magic arrows and tomahawks.
But as Todadaho planned his dirty death magic, the moon passed in front of the sun, and the day went dark. In Todadaho began to grow a strange feeling he had not known before. When the sun returned, Todadaho was still silent. He knew his magic was not that strong. And in the moment, he realized that love might be greater than hate. And he began to weep.
Tell him you forgive him and comb the snakes from his hair.
The sun thing was pretty cool, but watch this. Pretty cool, right?
Can you just finish this?
Oh, yeah.
Hiawatha combed away the snakes, and Todadaho was transformed into a beautiful man. There would be a healing, and then a great celebration. The people would finally know peace. They traveled together to the center of the Five Nations, and Deganawidah dug a great hole. The weapons of war would be buried there. The expression, to bury the hatchet, comes from this moment in time. It means to put in the past your anger, to live in a future of happiness. Once the weapons were placed, they planted a great pine. The pine, the symbol of these new United Nations. Once the pine tree was placed, a mighty eagle appeared.
Ooh, if you think you could do better, mate, I'm gonna miss her.
He landed atop the great pine. Deganawidah's work was done. He said goodbye and disappeared on his mystical canoe, never to be seen again. He has said that he will one day reappear when man needs him most. We will close on a song, and the snails have brought cakes for everyone to enjoy. Thank you again very much.
There's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Yeah. Father, Father, we don't need escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Oh, picket lines and picket signs.